The last time I'd been to India was 8 long years ago. I was 14. My age and inability to speak the language never allowed me a complete picture of what it was like there. Now 22 and knowing a bit more Telugu, I was excited to experience India and see my family. What I didn't know is that my experience would change me. I do it.
What you get for trying to hesitate? My homies go so hard they medicate. We never making it to heaven's gates. Hellbound, it's going down. Hellbound, it's going down.
This is India, a developing country of 1.3 billion people, many of whom living in abject poverty and compared to Western societal standards, downright misery. I saw manic, uncontrollable traffic power that went out every day. Damn near every street covered with trash or dirt. Enough mosquitoes to run my circulatory system dry if I didn't fend them off. Oh, and I'm a hairy dude, which would help, but these mosquitoes were elusive. I couldn't feel a thing until after they bit me. Only one bucket of water for a shower. Family living without everyday appliances like microwaves and fridges. A mattress that felt like I was sleeping on a damn brick. Houses that looked like huts made of brick or stone. Oppressive heat and no air conditioning. Hell, I saw people farming without modern day farming technology. Hard, arduous, physically taxing labor. And the day's labor probably only came out to a few mere dollars and cents. But to most, this is life. Not once did I see someone complaining, claiming that they were entitled to more. Comparatively, our living standards back home are 100 times better. The experience gave me a new perspective. To know I come from a country of these types of living conditions and have family still living in these conditions, I felt an enormous sense of gratitude. Back home, I had comforts not even rewarded to the wealthiest in this country. I felt responsible to make the best of the opportunity I had to be able to live in the US. There's always something that you're taking for granted, just because you're used to it. I'm reminded of a quote by Greek philosopher Epicurus. Do not spoil what you have by desiring what you have not. Remember that what you have now was once among the things you only hoped for back in California. Okay, that last part wasn't quite right, but fuck it. It's all about your perspective. Be grateful for what you do have. Peace.